Hello, my name is Turtle Army Jess, and welcome back to another Synfig Studio animation tutorial. Today, I'm going to show you how I build the head of a character model and some basic head movements. This is the third video in my tutorial series. You may want to watch the other ones first if you don't already have some experience in Synfig. Links are in the description, along with some timestamps if you want to skip around. So today, I'm going to build a model of a character's head and shoulders, specifically Caduceus from Critical Role. I'm first going to make a list of every action I want him to do, then I'll build the model, and finally I'll go over how I animate each of the actions. I want his head to be able to bob and tilt a bit. I want his large ears to wiggle. I also want him to blink and have his eyes move around. In addition to his eyes looking side to side, I also want his entire head to turn. Lastly, I want his expression to change into a smile. To put all of these things together in an example, I'm going to animate a complete GIF in which Caduceus watches a bumblebee fly past him, he smiles, and then says, "Hello, bees!" I won't cover lip sync in this video, but it will be the subject of my next video. Let's get started. I'm going to fast forward a bit through the drawing process to save some time. I'm not going to list every single step I do, just the steps that I find notable. So the first thing I did was save my project, always save often. The second thing I did was import my reference file. This allows me to get some help picking colors, and I don't have to switch between screens. My process is to kind of throw all of my shapes onto the canvas and then manipulate them until they look right. So this art is going to look like garbage at the start, but it will get better. Every shape I've drawn so far has been with either the circle tool or the draw tool, with the blend method set to composite. The exceptions are the inner ears, the shaved portion of the head, and his facial hair. I set those blend methods to onto so I don't have to spend a lot of time making sure the inner shapes line up with the edges of the outer shapes. On the shaved portions, I've also lowered the opacity a bit. Out of all of my shapes, his wavy hair in the front is the most complicated. I know that I'm going to have his head turning, which means that his hair will also have to move. It's easier to move and keep track of objects with fewer points, so my goal is to have the shape I want while using the fewest number of handles. To put that gradient color in his eye, I grouped together the iris and the highlight and added a gradient over the iris with the gradients blending set to onto. I'm going to save myself as much time as I can by duplicating and mirroring all of the shapes that I want to be symmetrical. I'm using the stretch layer to flip his ear, and I'm using the mirror tool for the tops of his eyes and eyebrows. Okay, now that all the basic shapes are here, I'm going to start adding in the structures I need to do my animations. I won't be moving anything below his head, so I'm going to group together every layer from his torso, shoulders, and neck. I'm also going to make the hair behind his head its own group. Next, I'm going to group together everything in his head. You can toggle your visible layers with the checkboxes in the Layers panel. I like to switch these on and off just to make sure that I've included every layer needed in that group. I have this group with every layer in his head together. I'm going to add a translate layer and a rotation layer inside the group at the top of the organization. If you have both a translate and a rotation layer affecting the same area, make sure the translate layer is always on top. I can then adjust these layers a bit to make sure they're working. I'm also going to copy-paste both the translate and rotation layers into that hair group behind his head. To wiggle the ears, group all of the layers of the ear together, then add a rotation layer inside the group as the top layer. Put the green origin where the ear would connect to the head. I want his eyes to follow or track the butterfly, so I'm going to add a translate layer to each iris. I'm adding the translate layer inside the iris group that I made while adding the gradient. I'm going to rearrange my layers a bit. I want to make sure that the top of the eye, this line, is the layer directly above the iris group. Between these two layers, I'm going to add a region for his eyelid. I'm making this region his skin tone and setting the blending to onto. I usually have four handles. I keep the top two in position and never move them. The bottom two, I will split the tangents to make a curve so that it exactly follows the top of the eye. When I start animating, I'll move this top of the eye down. As the black line moves, I'll move the eyelid with the same timing. I'm going to have Caduceus look from a 45-degree angle to directly facing the camera. His face is going to move across his head, and I want all of his face to be moving at the same time. It would look really bad if I messed up the timing and his eyes were moving faster than his mouth. I'm going to group his entire face together and add a translate layer to the top. For his expression change, I want him to go from neutral to a smile, so the corners of his mouth are going to curl up. He doesn't need anything extra for that. Lastly, I'm going to put this whole character into one group so that he's easier to copy-paste. Okay, that is all of the actions I want him to do. I'm just going to quickly draw a bee for him to watch and a flower for the bee to land on. Just like I mentioned in my first tutorial, I'm saving the Synfig project as one frame, because this is my reference file. When I want to animate, I'm going to make a new file and copy-paste these models into it. I'm going to save my file first and close my other project up here so that I don't have too many windows open. Synfig doesn't crash on me a lot, but when it does happen, it's usually while I'm animating, so save often. The bee is the easiest to animate, and it's what Caduceus is going to be focusing on, so I'm going to start with the bee. With animate mode on, I'm going to move the bee around a few different points in the timeline. Essentially, the bee is on the right, the bee is in the middle, the bee lands on the flower. I'm going to throw a keyframe at the beginning and end of the bee's movement. So I'm going to animate the head turn first. Making sure my two keyframe buttons are locked, I'm going to select the first keyframe and adjust Caduceus until he's looking at the bee. I'll shift his whole face in that direction, his right ear is going to come towards the viewer a bit, and his left ear is going to move back slightly. Lastly, I'll adjust his hair. Okay, the turn is done. Next, I'll move his eyes a bit so that he's watching the bee. This is my favorite part of animating because I have to move the eyes one at a time, and there's always a few frames of funny faces before I'm done. Something I want to add to make the animation feel more realistic is to adjust the timing of the head turn and the eyes. When people tend to look at things, their eyes will generally move faster than their head. The eyes kind of lead the head turn. I also want to feel like Caduceus is responding to and following the bee. When he's moving in sync, it seems like he knows what the bee is going to do ahead of time. I hope that makes sense. So I'm going to select the folder for his character group. These two yellow waypoints here represent every movement within this group, so all the animation I just did. I'll drag the start a few frames later in the timeline. Then I'm going to select each translate layer for his eyes, and make sure that the movement of the eyes starts faster than the turn of the head. To check my work, I'm going to use the preview function under File, Preview. Keep it at a low quality, and leave the frames at 12 frames per second. This is just to check my overall timing. This preview function generates quickly and is easier to check than fully rendering your animation each time. Just don't hit the play button until the whole thing is done rendering. Okay, after the bee lands, he's going to look at it for a few frames. Maybe 6 frames. A half second is a good pause. I'll add another keyframe at the end of the pause, and then animate the blink. A normal blink has eyelids closing for 2 frames, resting for 1 frame, and then 3 frames of opening. However, Caduceus is a really calm and chill character, so I imagine he blinks slower. I'll give him 4 frames to close, 2 frames of closed eyes, and 6 frames of opening. I'm going to take every chance I get to duplicate my waypoints to save time. Finally, while he's blinking, I'm going to take that time to add a slight ear wiggle and smile. Also, a tiny head tilt just because I think it's cute. Remember to add the tilt to the rotation layer that's on his head and the one on the hair behind his head. I'm going to check my timing once more. I wouldn't want that bee to feel like it's racing across the screen, and I really want to make sure that my blink feels calm. I think I'm going to go in and move a few of these keyframes around a bit. I feel like the bee is flying a little too fast. I feel like the blink isn't long enough, so I'm going to shift a few of those points around. Okay, let's render it. Yeah, that's pretty good. I will be demonstrating how to do lip sync in my next tutorial so I can add Caduceus saying, "Hello, bees." Leave me a comment if you have any questions or recommendations for what kind of Synfig tutorials that I should make next. Thanks again for watching. Until next time.